Do you know how to spot those extraordinary companies with a unique edge over their competitors? Do you know how to quickly identify companies with an economic moat? In our previous video, Warren Buffett's Moat Strategy, we explored the qualitative aspects of identifying an economic moat. In practice, we also need to find some quantitative indicators that can help us to quickly identify and assess an economic moat. So, in this video, we'll equip you with the financial tools to rapidly identify those standout companies. Before we dive into specific indicators, it's essential to underscore the concept of durability. When it comes to evaluating potential investments, durability holds paramount importance. Warren Buffett believes that a company with consistent financial performance over several years is more likely to have an enduring competitive advantage that can maintain its profitability and fend off competition. Therefore, he places a lot of emphasis on the long-term trend in a company's financial metrics rather than focusing on a single year's performance. Now let's take a look at which financial indicators can reflect an economic moat. First up, we have the high net profit margin. This indicator measures the ratio of net profit to total revenue. When evaluating companies with a durable competitive advantage, Warren Buffett emphasizes the significance of the percentage of net earnings to total revenues compared to their competitors. To illustrate this point, imagine having two companies. The first company earns $2 billion on $10 billion in total revenue, while the second company earns $5 billion on $100 billion in total revenue. If given the choice between these two, Buffett would opt for the company earning $2 billion. The company generating $2 billion in net earnings is earning 20% on total revenues. In contrast, the company with $5 billion is earning only 5% on its total revenues. A remarkable example is Coca-Cola, a truly fantastic business that earns an impressive 22% on its total revenues. Equally astounding is Moody's, another exceptional company that achieves a 25% return. These remarkable percentages are a testament to the superior underlying business economics of these companies. Let's explore another important indicator commonly used in the industry. Return on equity. ROE is a measure of how efficiently a company is using its equity to generate profits. A high ROE often indicates that the company is able to effectively use shareholders' capital to generate returns, which may be due to a stronger economic moat. However, we must exercise caution when solely relying on ROE to assess the presence of an economic moat. ROE has its limitations that need to be considered. Firstly, ROE includes non-recurring gains or losses, which can distort the overall picture. These gains or losses might not reflect the sustainable performance of the company's core operations. Secondly, ROE is also influenced by leverage. It's important to note that a project or investment with a low return rate can appear to have a high overall return if it is accompanied by significant leverage. Therefore, while ROE provides valuable insights, it's crucial to consider these limitations and evaluate other indicators alongside it. To overcome ROE's limitations, let's consider another indicator, return on invested capital, or ROIC. ROIC, also known as the investment capital return rate, focuses on the real return a company can achieve after investing capital to expand production. To calculate ROIC, return on invested capital, you can use the following formula. ROIC equals net operating profit after tax divided by invested capital, where NOPAT is the company's operating profit after taxes, and invested capital is the total amount of capital invested in the business, including debt and equity. Invested capital can be calculated as invested capital equals total assets minus non-interest-bearing current liabilities. ROIC is a useful metric for investors because it measures the return a company is generating on the capital it has invested in its business. A high ROIC indicates that a company is generating strong returns on its invested capital, which can be a sign of a durable competitive advantage and a strong economic moat. Generally, companies with an ROIC greater than 10% are considered good companies. Those with an ROIC greater than 20% are considered excellent, and companies with an ROIC greater than 30% are regarded as great companies. These are just a few examples of financial indicators that can reflect an economic moat. There are several other factors that can also indicate the presence of an economic moat, including but not limited to free cash flow, revenue growth rate, PE, market share, dividend growth, and dividend payout ratio. These will likely be covered in upcoming sessions. Remember, measuring the economic moat is not an exact science and requires a comprehensive analysis of various qualitative and quantitative factors. So, it's important to note that these financial measures should be used in conjunction with qualitative analysis and a deep understanding of the company's industry dynamics. Join us in our next video as we continue our exploration into the captivating world of investing.